Hi, this is Dr. Nemechek of the Nemechek Protocol in Buckeye, Arizona. I want to talk to you about this idea of inflammatory foods, all right? The vast majority of things that they speak of as foods being inflammatory is really kind of a confusion, and it is not true. The foods themselves are not per se inflammatory. The problem is people with bacterial overgrowth, all right, and leaky gut or bacterial translocation, those bacteria, my old fish living where the birds are scenario, all right, when you end up with that, those fish bacteria, the bacteria from the colon, love a wide variety of foods, love them. They love carbs, they love gluten, they love tomatoes and seasons and chocolate and lettuce and milk peppers and all that kind of stuff. Orange juice, fruit, they can love all that stuff. And when people commonly say, oh, I can't, you know, if I eat nightshades, my joints just hurt. You know, it's inflammatory. I've read all about that. It's inflammatory. Well, when you fix their intestinal overgrowth with Xifaxan, the nightshades quit bothering them. So I had one gentleman actually from Pakistan was quite upset because suddenly he couldn't eat his very, very spicy food he had eaten his whole life, and it made him feel sick. It was all inflammatory. You know, we treated him with the rifaximin or Xifaxan antibiotic, and within a couple weeks he could eat his foods and they weren't inflammatory. All right. So one of the big things for these inflammatory foods is just because people have bacterial overgrowth, and when you fix that, it goes away. They can eat the foods, they don't bother them. You know, oh, suddenly tomatoes and spices don't bother them, or the wine doesn't bother you. You know, usually within about 2 weeks. Now, there's another aspect in the intestinal tract that causes things to be inflammatory, and that is your autonomics, specifically your vagus nerve, which carries all the parasympathetic signaling from the brain and completely controls inflammation. Your vagus nerve tightly regulates the area immediately around the small intestine. So if you imagine you have your small intestine here, this tube, right on the outside, immediately just one cell away from the inside, okay, is 80% of all of your white blood cells are right there. And if you get overgrowth and leakage, that's why this stuff leaks in there and stimulates the immune system. But even after that, after you take rifaximin, the leaky gut repairs itself in about 2 weeks, you can still be left with some trouble kind of regulating inflammation because the vagus nerve is damaged from that, your leaky gut inflammation. The vagus nerve can get damaged from the omega-6 oils, all right? Lack of omega-3s, all that can damage your vagus nerve, and that can take a while to heal. But so now things like gluten will, after leaky gut is healed, gluten still gets into that space immediately around the small intestine in everybody. And if your vagus nerve doesn't work right, that's why gluten makes you feel inflammatory. It's not because you have gluten. It's because your parasympathetics are damaged, right? It's just like nightshades are not inflammatory. It's just because you got SIBO and leaky gut, and they're allowed to leak in and abnormally stimulate the white blood cells. Once you fix the leaky gut, the nightshades don't bother you. Once you fix your vagus nerve and your parasympathetics, all right, things like gluten and some foods don't bother you, okay? So in the vast majority of people who are claimed to have inflammation from food, it's not because of the food per se. It's all some other thing that can be fixed. You can fix leaky gut and you can repair your vagus nerve, all right? The Nemechek protocol goes a long way for repairing the vagus nerve, even without a vagus nerve stimulator, all right? So don't think you have to have that to fix that. So you can go a long way with that. So my point is, once you get started, these foods that you've kind of been trained to be like fearful of or whatnot, go ahead and start adding some of those back in. You know, life's nice when you have a variety of food and you got different nutrients and things like that, all right? Go ahead and add that stuff back in. So hope that's helpful. This is Dr. Nemechek from the Nemechek Protocol in Buckeye, Arizona. Everybody have a great day.